Krishna says the sahun and grindani
hariseta dhanamsa.
If somebody wants to be actually devotee of Krishna, at the same time keeps his material attachment, then Krishna's business is he takes out everything material so that same person he becomes, dependent on Krishna. So that actually happened to my life. I was obliged to come to this movement to take up this very seriously. And I was dreaming that Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur is calling me. Please come up. So I was sometimes horrified. What is this? I have to give up my family life. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur is calling me. I have to take sannyas. Oh, I was horrified. But I saw a similar time calling.
Thank you. here. Otherwise, why would you bring me to this terrible place?
The captain of the ship was appreciating that if the Atlantic Ocean had shown its usual face, perhaps he would have died. And he had a dream that Krishna was rowing that boat. Perhaps in the most discouraging time, Krishna gave him a vision, some sign that perhaps there would be some success to his mission.
You are so kind upon this useless soul, but I do not know why you have brought me here. Now you can do whatever you like with me. But I guess you have some business here. Otherwise, why would you bring me to this terrible place? Come under the control of the illusory energy by your will. And therefore, if you like, by your will, they can also be released from the clutches of illusion. Somehow or other, O Lord, you have brought me here to speak about you. Now, my Lord, it is up to you to make me a success or failure, as you like. O Lord, I am just like a puppet in your hands. So if you have brought me here to dance, then make me dance, O Lord, make me dance as you like.
I'm Reed Collins. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. A hypnotic rhythmic chant of 16 words has replaced LSD and other drugs for some in New York's East Village. On 2nd Avenue and 1st Street is a storefront in which a Hindu Swami has set up shop. There, his American disciples are learning about Krishna consciousness.
As in New York, Bhaktivedanta Swami gathers sincere followers. The Hare Krishna movement begins to grow.
The founder came at exactly the right time, Larry. He came in 1965 when American culture was in turmoil. People were looking for new answers, for new ways to explore. So along came a man who had a different way. It was very, Prabhupada was, his power was really spiritual, and he laid out a new path for people to follow. Yeah. So the religion became a bridge between East and West.
Swami Prabhupada was known as a scholar, a philosopher, a cultural ambassador, a prolific author, a religious leader, a spiritual teacher, a social critic, and a holy man. He was not one of those modern entrepreneurial gurus who come to the West with slickly packaged, watered-down versions of Eastern spirituality. Swami Prabhupada was, rather, a true holy man, a person who was called Acharya, which means a master who teaches by his own example. of the man who influenced the lives of millions and made Hare Krishna a household word.
We lived a few blocks from the temple, and one time there was no money for rent. We were behind about 2 months, and we were in very grave danger of being evicted. Malti and I walked out on the street, on Ashbury Street, one morning early to go to the temple, and walked to the temple for kirtan. And there were all these $100 bills blowing down the sidewalk. One after another, we just started running around the street picking up $100 bills. No one ever, there wasn't a person on the street. No one ever figured out where that came from. These kind of things, I could always harken back to the magic days of Prabhupada. These are kind of things we began to expect of Krishna. If you take a risk for Krishna and stick your neck out and spread Krishna consciousness, Krishna must help you personally. And those who see Krishna closest take the biggest risk for him.
Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Ananta koti Vaishnava vrinda ki jai. Namacharya Srila Haridasa Thakur ki jai.
The yogis were speaking, and they said to him, this was in Calcutta, went to where the Victoria Monument was. And he told them, oh, I used to climb up, they had the scaffolding, they were building this, and I would climb up the scaffolding. I said, oh, Prabhupada, you were fearless. And he stopped and he said, was? I still am. Otherwise, how could I have come to your country?
Somebody wants to be actually devotee of Krishna, at the same time keeps his material attachment, then Krishna's business is he takes away everything material so that same person he becomes, dependent on Krishna. So that actually happened to my life. I was obliged to come to this movement to take up this very seriously. And I was dreaming that Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur is calling me. Please come out with me. So I was sometimes horrified. Oh, what is this? I have to give up my family life. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur is calling me. I have to take sannyas. Oh, I was horrified. But I saw similar time calling me. So anyway, it is by His grace I was forced to give up my family life and so-called business life. And He brought me somewhere or other in preaching His gospel. So, this is a memorable day. What He deserved. I am trying little bit and you are all helping me. So I have to thank you more. You are actually representative of my Guru Maharaj. Because you are helping me in executing the order of my Guru Maharaj. Thank you very much.
Forest to be green, each tree must be green. So it's no use just one or two people being, you know, like this. You'd have to make the whole of society, if they had that understanding.
Krishna.